This is Tracy with RoadDawgOnline.com and Ron Gannaway.
The bass player for Steve Wariner was Kyle Tullis, and he was out to see Jonah L, and we met. The strange thing about that was we both from Chattanooga. Oh. Kind of knew of one another a little bit, but they never met, you know, and then he was like, what are you doing? And you playing? Or do you, you know, would you be interested in trying out, you know, auditioning for Steve Wariner's job? It's coming up. I'd always, you know, loved his records and his singing, guitar playing. So I was like, yeah, so here we go back on the road. But that was the beginning of 89.
We did a show together at the Bear Creek Steakhouse in Montpelier, Louisiana. It was probably 93, 94 or something.
I want to say,
maybe something like
that. Yeah, you know what? It was in 89. I started with him, but I had that same, I remember I had that same drum kit for a couple of years. I want to say it was maybe, it could have been 91 or something.
Yeah, and
90, 91, something.
I was so green, man. That was like one of the first shows we'd ever done where we opened for a national act. And I'm like, whoa, I get to play his drums? And yeah, like, yeah, you use the guys. I was like, oh, because I'd seen your picture in ads, like ProMark ads and Modern Drummer.
I'm so sorry.
It was awesome. And I was like, oh my God, that's Ron Gannaway. You, man, it was like, I was touching greatness, man. And I got to play your kit. Oh. And man, I still, I apologize for gurming you so bad. Or gurming is like, you know, asking millions of questions. But it was awesome. You were so cool to me, man. So
yeah, fun. I remember that.
And ever since then, man, I've kind of followed your career. And especially when I moved to Nashville, man, you were one of the guys. And you've always been the sweetest guy to everyone. You mentioned Ron Gannaway, man. There's no bad word. And if there is, I'm going to take him out. You did the Steve thing. And with that, man, you did that for quite a few years, right?
Yeah. And it's kind of difficult. Because it's about a decade. It was 89 to 99. But then, you know, he stopped touring for a while. And then I was kind of in and out with him for a couple of years there. 2000, 2001, right around that area. Playing a few shows with him while playing with other people as well. But I spent a good solid 10 years there, which was really terrific because it was a lot of videos. Fortunate to get on a few of his records. Around 90, I think it was around 92, 3, he did an instrumental record on Arista that he produced, and it was, you know, kind of in the vein of like a Chet record. I mean, it was, you know, a guitar record. So I had an opportunity to play on a few of those, too. I let my guitar do the talking. Burning the Roadhouse Down, and a few other records, Two Teardrops, Faith Is You, Greatest Hits Package for those records. So yeah, the Holes in the Floor Heaven record, and a few other tunes on that record. And then, you know, being able to went to Europe, we've been to Japan a couple of times, very exciting, man. And you know, through him, I had an opportunity because of he's in the certified guitar player world with the greats. I mean, Chet Atkins and Larry Carlton. So I had an opportunity not only to meet these people, but to play with Chet and to be told you're going to play with Chet about 15 minutes before
Wow.
you're going to play with him on television, and it's live. So, and here's the song, by the way. Here's how the song goes. Here we go. And just watch Chet, you know. Okay. Here we go, you know. Played with him on TV, did a couple of little things in Nashville with him, and then had an opportunity to play a set with Larry Carlton through Steve, and he needed a drummer for this event that we did with at the Ryman with Larry and Chet. So, you know, just over the years, my Lord, there's been lots of great musicians that I've jammed with and played with through being in Steve's band, and have the opportunity to meet some great you know, musicians through him, that his heroes. So that was a great thing, And like I said, I kind of came out of it when he started slowing down a bit with the touring. Still continue to record a little bit with him.
Yeah, you can. You guys have a great, cool project coming up.
Yeah, he just finished this thing, and I just got a copy this week. It's called Steve Wariner CGP, which is Certified Guitar Player. Which he was certified by Chet Atkins himself, but it's Steve Wariner CGP, my tribute to Chet, and it's a record on Select Tone Records, Steve's label, and man, it's a piece of work. It's beautiful. There's a lot of strings, beautiful guitar playing, of course, and a lot of great guests. He uses a lot of the actual guitars that Chet played back from the day, and Vecchio and Gretsch, and all these different great guitars. So I was excited to be involved in 3-4 tunes on that record. And there's a medley on the record that I've been told that Chet put together of songs that were hits that he had produced. You know, Don Gibson and different people through the 60s, 50s and 60s. He had made this arrangement, but they never played it or recorded it, to my understanding. So Steve has put that together with strings and guitar. It's beautiful, man. And he's got everything from some actual fiddle that Chet Atkins started out on fiddle, playing at the beginning of the record, all the way through to some Brazilian music that Chet was connected with these two brothers from Brazil that were involved with the Del Vecchio guitar. And there's a song on there that Steve does. It's just unbelievable guitar playing. And it's just a beautiful record. It's a lot of different styles of music in there. He's got the sort of mountain music going into, you know, maybe what a lot of people know of Chet, you know, the picking, the straight country picking, but also through the period where he's more contemporary, kind of coming from maybe more like an LA jazz period when Chet played. So it's going to be really, really nice when it comes out and to be out in June. So.
Oh, cool. Well,
so
that'll be.
And all kinds of players on it. You know, Tony Migliore's on the piano, and Paul Imes on some of the drum tracks. Steve's brother Terry actually plays drums on one track, and a lot of great people. Paul Yandell from Chet's band is on there on guitar.
Oh, wow.
So, gotta check it out.